The neobladder, which can be performed in men or women, again, is going to store urine. So one thing someone needs to do really is retrain themselves to urinate. This neobladder is not the same as the bladder that one was born with. The muscle structure is different, and the capacity to actually hold urine starts out to be a little less. Over time, it'll stretch up. And what that means is, in the early period after surgery, a patient would have a catheter for a few weeks to allow it to heal up. But then there's a period of time where the neobladder is stretching up and gaining capacity. So that means patients will functionally be urinating frequently. In other words, every 1 or 2 hours. There's also some time needed to gain control of the urine from the neobladder. So there is a period of time where patients actually have little control over their neobladder and will leak urine, so that pads may be necessary. But after the first 3 to 4 months, most patients have very good urine control during the daytime. Nighttime takes a little bit longer, but after several months, they can also gain good control at that time as well. Some patients may have trouble emptying the neobladder over time. This happens in about 5 to 10% of men. That's 5 to 10 out of 100 people. 5 to 10 out of 100 men. But it happens a lot more frequently in women. Probably about half the women or more have trouble emptying the neobladder over time. When that happens, patients have to drain the neobladder using a catheter. It sounds difficult, but we teach all our neobladder patients how to do it. They have the equipment at home. It's not difficult to do. They can bring catheters with them. And frankly, when people have started doing it, it becomes just part of their normal everyday lives.